is a great favorite written by the author Xue Mo in a plain and realistic style. Through describing the living conditions for a group of people in Western China, the author reveals the survival of mankind and the mutual environmental problems for human world. It also reveals the karmic cycles, where humans' pursuit to satisfy their desires leads to their own destruction. This is what is different from Desert Rites. In Desert Hunters, every section is a vivid scene of life, and every chapter is a grand depiction of the society. It forms an epic historical picture in the whole work. There are more than 50 characters and depicts more than 20 species of animals in the book features. The stories of the book revolve around a place called the Peak Belling Wheel. All people and all life in the area, including wolves and sheep, falcons and rabbits, birds and bugs, foxes and rats, rely on this water wheel for survival. Imaging of all figures demonstrated fierceness and kindness, suffering and joy, happiness and endurance, nature and field, greed and strife. All things seem to be distant but familiar, vast but subtle. Every character, every animal seems to be the mouth of God in this book, telling stories about their own transgressions and the following aftermath. Through layers and layers of conflicts between humans and animals, humans and nature, and humans for their own fate, the book tells us the tragedies of humanity are rooted in greed, hatred, and ignorance. Those who transgress, those who break the laws of nature, are bound to be punished, bound to suffering in the desert of the soul, and bound to become a prey that is being hunted on the hunting field of the soul. It is like the coronavirus spreading around the world, ruthlessly attacking everybody around us, paralyzing industries and forcing countries into long-term lockdown, spreading fear and anxiety among all people. However, through the actions of the heroes and heroines, the book also tells us how to create a harmonious conservation between people and their inner selves, between different people and between human and nature. The following people will like this book: those who love animals and those who wonder about how to create balance between human and nature, how to make a living, and how to form a harmonious conservation between people's life and their own inner world.